It's the last day of the year, just a few training sessions left, and then it's time to draw the line and see how much training I did in this year. I did 5.5k swim in the morning, and now I have 3 hour ride with some intervals. Training is done for the year, and in previous years I shared my training stats, and that always seemed to be popular, so I will do that again this year. I keep a training log. I don't think it's something necessary, but it can be useful on some occasions. For example, if things are not going as well as before, you can take a look on what type of training you did before. I log my training into a simple Excel sheet, so I have months spread in tabs here at the bottom, and then in the first few columns I have basic stats like time and distance or ascent on the bike. Then in the next part is workout descriptions, and then in the last part is well, how I felt, average pace or similar stuff. Then here I have stats for the month and stats for the week. As you can see from the table, I train 2 or 3 times per day. This year I had a total of 1162 hours. That's about 48 days. On average that's 22 hours per week, but it also includes weeks with races when you taper for the race, or where you have a little bit of rest after race, and also end of season break. So I would say in a normal training week I train about 30 hours per week. This year's training volume is not a record. I had, well, for the past 7 years I keep similar volume, and I know that I had some years with more than 1200 hours. Biggest month of this year was July with 130 hours. That's also not a record. I think it was a couple of hours short of the record. And biggest week is 35 hours, which is also not a record. I think my biggest week ever was something about 37 hours. This year I swam 1048 kilometers. On average that's 20k per week, but I would say in a normal training week that I'm around 20 to 25k. I swim 5 to 6 times per week. My longest swim this year was 7.4k. It was 500 meters warm up, then 16 times 400, and then 500 meters cool down. That's also not a record. No records were broken this year. I swam 10k one time before. I did 100s. More than half of my training was on the bike. I did 560 hours on the road and another 50 hours on the trainer. I did 16,500 kilometers on the road, and if we had time on the trainer, it would be around 18,000 kilometers for the year. My longest ride was here in Makarska. It was 188k, but my longest time in the saddle was actually when I was in Switzerland. I was doing this Stelvio loop with multiple alpine mountain passes. It was only 183k, but it took me 7.5 hours, as it has more than 4,200 meters of elevation gain. This year in total I had 222,000 meters of elevation gain, so it's like I climbed Mount Everest for a little bit more than 25 times. I spent a little bit more than 250 hours running, and in that time I managed to cover a little bit less than 3,300 kilometers. My longest training run was just over 40 kilometers when I was in St. Moritz, but most of my long runs are around 30 kilometers. In total I did 35,000 meters of elevation gain, which is a little bit less than 4 times Mount Everest. Of course I could have done more kilometers, more volume in training, but my goal is not just to add up kilometers but to get faster, and you need to balance volume and intensity. I know that there are some guys who train less and who are faster than me, but I'm sure there are also guys who train more. Everyone needs to find a balance that suits him. This was a good year, and I hope the next one will be even better. I wish you all happy and successful 2018. Bye!